Watch out, ladies and gentlemen. That I'm wearing a different hat this morning. Let me talk about that hat. In my most recent set of lessons, I talked about the archetypal foundations of the blues harmonica, and I realized that I had left one very important archetype out. And that, remember I talked about the warrior, I talked about the lover, and I talked about the painter? Well now, ladies and gentlemen, I spent many years as a street musician. What's the governing archetype of the street musician? It's the trickster. He goes to the crossroads, that's where you meet him. I used to play in front of Grand Central Station, this would have been the fall of 85, with a guy named Bill Taft, who later moved to Atlanta and joined a group called Jody Grind. Bill and I worked outside the Beacon Theater, when the Allman Brothers played there in 85, fall of 85. Spring of 86, I played with Bill Collins, who went off to Paris with me and played all over Europe. I'm a street musician at heart, and I've been thinking long and hard about today's lesson, which is the 41st. I have completed my 40 lessons in something like 40 days. And so I want to move this thing forward, and in fact I want to get risky and daring, and I want to begin by talking about why I think you guys and you gals are grooving to what I do. I'm still panting because I was playing hard. And that is because I think for all my harp nerd ability to rationalize the instrument, to sit down, to take it apart, and to tell you what I'm doing and what's really going on inside blues harmonica, I haven't forgotten, I haven't lost sight of one crucial thing, which is none of us would be committing ourselves to this instrument if it weren't our way of being free. It's a way of living your freedom, expressing your freedom. There's a kind of, I would say, there's the sort of the inner harmonica player in people is really the inner anarchist. See this hat? This was the hat that I used for many years. Not actually when U2 came by in 1987, but this is a hat that's seen quite a bit of street wear. And so there's something that I used to do. Something I used to do when I played the street, and actually I learned about it from some professional buskers, some serious buskers over in Europe, and it was called making a pitch. Now, I want to do something very interesting. I want to hold up the terms of use that I found on YouTube, and I want you to take a good hard look at them, because I have absolutely no desire to violate either the letter or the spirit of these terms of use. So let me read them to you. Your use of the website, your meaning mine, because I'm somebody who's uploading videos, as permitted, is solely for your personal, non-commercial use. Now, I mean, and it's very important, we do not want to violate the letter or the spirit of this, because we know that, you know, none of the big movie studios upload trailers and stuff. I mean, that we're not allowed to do that. And also it says, if you take a look at the second item here, it says, in connection with user submissions, you further agree that you will not post advertisements or solicitations of business. So, what is a street musician to do when he realizes that he would love to be able to spread his knowledge, his joy, and the information that he's gathered over a lifetime of harmonica teaching? Well, I had to think long and hard about this, and I consulted my inner trickster. And what I decided is, well, I remembered actually a dialogue that I'd had with my tax person back in the mid-1980s when I said that I was basically scrounging for a living in New York. And I said, you know, is the money that I get as a street musician considered income? And the tax person said, well, no, that's actually considered begging. So I thought, well, you know, I'm too proud to beg, but as a street musician, I always enjoyed the idea that what I was doing was putting myself out there and then allowing people without any compulsion, with no commercial considerations or advertisements particularly. Really, I was out there because I was just crazy. I was truly whacked when I was a solo blues harmonica player in the fall of 85. And so I'm trying to remind myself of that spirit, and this is what I'm going to do. I have decided that I'm going to create a faith community. This is not for commercial purposes at all. And we're going to do something that hopefully it's unprecedented on YouTube, and hopefully it doesn't start something crazed. This is what I want to suggest. You know, if I've got 800 and something subscribers to my channel, and if every one of them actually felt like making the smallest donation, a dollar or two in an envelope, the way you would at a church if you really had almost nothing, and were to mail it to me, I would have, if only I got a dollar or two from every single person, every single one of you guys and gals, and overseas too, money orders allowed, I would have enough money to start up a website from which I would be able to upload all kinds of stuff. And at a low cost. Okay, you guys, I could start a commercial website, but you know, I got a woman up front is because I got a wife and I got a kid, and I, as Mr. Satan used to say, the baby needs diapers. So this is what I'm going to do, and then I'm going to give you a couple of more lessons today. And I'm going to tell you everything you always want to know about the four-hole draw, but we're afraid to ask. We're going to probe the mysteries of that hole right in the middle of the harp. But this is what I want. I want you guys to take a good hard look, okay? Because I am starting a faith community, and it's called the Joyous Disciples of Blues Harmonica Anarchism. I happen to have a P.O. box. It just sort of materialized today. I sent out to the universe, and I took a drive by the Oxford, Mississippi post office. And while the box that I have is not big enough to accept the sorts of donations that some of you might like to give, including farm animals, which we would love here in Mississippi, it will accept any gift that anybody should feel motivated to give. Now, I realize that some of you are just shaking your heads and going, I don't believe it. I knew there was a... So I just want to tell you, if you don't feel moved to give, don't give. I'm a street musician. I am crazed. I would not have been out here for 40 lessons. For 5 weeks I've been out here, folks, on the street, you know, on the YouTube street, throwing my good music out at you and asking for nothing in return. I realize at a certain point you've got to make a space where if people feel moved to give you something in return, they can. Now, again, this is not commercial. Remember the trickster. You've got to cultivate that inner trickster. So this is a faith community. In fact, I'm thinking actually of doing a media fire, just uploading everything I have and just saying, if you like what you see, you know, send me a donation. I think that's the way ministers work, and I am clearly a crazed minister of this crazy little instrument. I've got a minute and 40 seconds for this lesson, so I just want to say that the dollar or two would be wonderful if you felt like giving that to me and just sending it to this address. Here it is, Adam Gussow, P.O. Box 2216, Oxford, Mississippi, 38655, and that's in the USA. If you don't feel like donating, that's fine. When I used to give harmonica lessons, I charged $35. Now, you go online, you know, Dave Barrett Masterclass, you can get a first-person lesson for $75. Dennis Gruenling charges $65, I think. I'm not giving private lessons. I might down the line, but I'm really not thinking about that at all. I would just like to spread my information through the as part of the Joyous Disciples of Blues Harmonica Anarchism. Okay, this is what I'm going to do next lesson. I'm going to upload two lessons, and we're going to be anarchists. And I want to talk about the four-hole draw. So, four-hole draw, and I've only got... Ooh, I don't have much time. I have 30 seconds. I gotta end this one, folks. I'll come right back at you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to take a short break. We'll be right back at you with another set, so stick around. Don't go anywhere. Bye-bye.